Hey, I'm Kelvin with Hubstaff, and in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to create a weekly timesheet in Excel. All right, so like I said, we're gonna be creating a weekly timesheet in Excel, and by the time we're done with everything, your timesheet should look something like this, and you're gonna be able to customize everything here, including your brand colors, and you'll be able to add your company logo. Now here from the left to right, we have a couple different columns. You're gonna see date, tasks, start time, end time, regular hours, overtime hours, total hours, and a notes section. That was quite a lot. Now before we fill out the formulas, I'm going to add 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. for start and end times here. So we have a full 8-hour day, which is gonna be pretty typical, I would say. That way we have that prepared for the formulas moving forward. Now let's start with the total hours column. We're going to place our formulas in the regular, total, and overtime hours sections so everything fills out for us automatically. Now starting with total hours, we're going to input the following formula, and I'm gonna just copy and paste this. And so that's total hours equals end time minus start time times 24. Now I'm gonna have this on the screen so you can see this as I'm explaining it. The one thing that might seem odd here is multiplying the formula by 24, but we do have to do so because Excel registers a whole day as a value of 1. So as a numerical example, 12 hours would result in a value of 0.5. Next, let's input the formula for regular hours. And this column clearly depends on the cap that you have set for a regular work week. But for this example, we'll assume it's a 40-hour work week with 8-hour days. And anything beyond that, we're going to consider overtime. So the formula is gonna look like this. Again, I'm copy and pasting this right in here because I've got it set up, but I will have these formulas up on the screen as we go so you can see them laid out. So this is an if statement. So we're gonna tell this column, depending on what the hours are, we want things to be moved over to another column. So we want this to be locked in at 8 hours because that is the max allowable regular hours in a day. Anything beyond that, again, like we said, is gonna be considered overtime. So using this equation paired with the equation we're going to have in the next column, we're going to be able to move the extra hours over to the overtime hours column pretty easily. Now let's move over to overtime hours. And the formula here is gonna look a little similar to what we just created. I'm gonna copy and paste it again and place it right there. So it does look a little similar to the other equation that I just added to the regular hours column, but there's a little bit of a difference here in terms of the structure of the equation itself. Now here, we're gonna be telling this column to gather any of the additional hours from the regular hours column and show them right here. So to show you what this looks like, I'm gonna change the hours here so we have a 10-hour day. And you can see that it still kept the cap here of 8 hours, but now we have 2 hours that have shown up in the overtime hours column. So you can see how everything's very cleanly, automatically moving the numbers around to the appropriate columns. Now that we have regular and overtime hours set up, we're gonna calculate employee pay. And to do that, we're gonna multiply the hours worked by what their hourly rate is, which is pretty straightforward. And as you can see at the top of the screen here, we have a designated cell for the hourly rate of the employee. So what we're gonna do is use this simple equation, copy and pasting it in. And then we're going to carry this equation over to the overtime column as well. Now this is multiplying by that base hourly rate. If you have a different rate for overtime, like time and a half, for example, you can add a separate cell up top to calculate that as well. The last small thing I want to show you is how you can freeze the different rows of your timesheet, which is going to help keep everything nice and clean as you scroll through the different entries. So right up top here, everything from row 1 to 6 is going to stay in place, and you're done. Now, the very last thing I want to talk about before we wrap up this video is restricting the access to these timesheets. So what I mean by that is making it so that only managers can access the timesheets after they've been submitted. And this is going to help prevent things like fraud, overpayments, accidental entries. Those are all very important to avoid when you have manually entered timesheets like this. So what we recommend doing is setting up 2 separate folders in some type of online storage option like Google Drive or Dropbox, for example. And what you want to do is allow the timesheets to be submitted in one folder, and then once they are submitted, move them over to a different folder that is restricted to manager access only. So that way, employees can submit the timesheets, and then once they've been submitted, they can no longer access them because they've been moved over to that separate folder. And there you have it. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, feel free to hit that thumbs up right down below. And if you are new here, consider subscribing to the channel. And if you are interested, we do have templates like the one we just set up here in this video back on our website. So I will have a link to download those templates right down below in the video description. Thanks again for watching, and we'll talk to you next time.